This is part 5 of Espeon. Today we're going to finish up for Nick, and then we're going to start the ears. Because this is a step-by-step tutorial, I need to make our stitches. Therefore, I need to make our stitches of our neck here, but it's not that relevant for most of you, so just skip where I started the ears. It's more relevant and it's more not obvious how to make. This is the result of this part, so let's show you some stuff. So here is the right ear, left ear. Here is the neck. And the last stitch of the neck. And let's begin. So in order to start, I'm gonna need to reduce from a 5x4 to a 4x4. So we are more or less over here, and I'm going to make a few more stitches over here on the neck. So I'm going to make a stitch, a 4x4, by reducing the middle strings, this string, and this string. Okay, 2, 2, 2, and 2 middle strings. So let's do it. How I'm going to do it? Yeah, I think ordinary way. Really not that important to do to see. Oh, wow, huge mess. Let's do it one by one, I think. It's really a mess right now. So, sometimes do it the old way. It'll make it simpler to watch. I like messy things. Makes it more adventurous, but you guys won't understand anything from it. So I'm going to do it one by one. 1 plus 1. Four strings on the on this side, and you can see four strings. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we'll do over here. Next, we'll take the string. Yeah, I need to take this one and remove this one. No, removing this one. So taking these two and weaving it this on this side here. So I'll take first this string. Over and over under. Yada yada. This one also. I'm gonna take. Here. And what's next? Next, gonna need to. These two and these two, of course. So, I don't know. Taking this, for example. This guy. What I'll do after that, I'll make another free. Finishing a nick. It's pretty rough finishing this nick and then continue to the ears. Remember, I'm gonna need to take taking the middle string on this side and I'm going to move it to the trash here, to the middle. taking off of this one and adding to the center. Moving this one to the center. It looks good, I think. Let's check. Here it looks good. See, I'm always looking at the loops here. See? Make sure that you don't see any holes or any problems, you know? And yeah, I think one last time to check. And we will continue. I think, yeah, so I'm showing you, I'm intentionally showing you why I like these things here. As for example, if I would take this and move it too much, you'll see that this creates a little hole here. And you don't want things like that. So make sure you don't get what I did right now. And yeah, let's just continue. So next, the same stitch. So the same 4x4 stitch. So let's make it. First of all, I need to move this wire. No, okay. And also, sometimes the strings get tangled, so try to move them. So I don't know. I was thinking to cut this, to cut the these two purple strings. I'll do it later. And I'll cut these two purple strings getting in my way. We'll use it later on. So let's make a few more stitches. What's wrong here is this. I need to weave it. Like, reweave it. Okay, here is an example how to fix loops. So you can see this guy here is not that great, this loop. So what I'll do is just pull it and squeeze it a little bit. Let's see if now it's better, I think. Maybe even more. See? Yeah, I think it's better. Let's just take another one. So. So, just made over and under, moved them, and I'll weave this guy. Come on. Almost done the, I don't know, third one. Now I'm taking these two and do it simultaneously. Maybe not. So we are right now made 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 before stitches. So in the espeon, on the other one, we are now 1, 2, 3, 4. We are now 1, 2, 3, 4. We are now over here at this spot. So I'm going to make one last stitch for the neck to be this one, and then I'm going to start the ears. So let's continue. Let's make the last 4x4 stitch as for now. So we almost finished off the stitch. Okay, looks good to me. So now I'm going to start the ears, these two guys. For each ear, we will need 5 strings, 2 lavender strings, and another 3 purple strings. This kind of purple, as you can see, it's only called, by Rexus, it's called just purple. Links will be in my description, of course. Now, we'll need 1 long string to be lavender. This one long string is going to be 1.2 meters, about 4 feet. And another other 4 strings, 1 lavender and 3 purples, will be 0.8 meters, that is about 2.5 feet. Now, let's move on to the example, because you, as you can see, the Espeon itself, you can't really see what's going on, how I added the strings. So let's just move on to the Espeon, our Espeon. And I already did a part I wanted to show you before going to do it. So as you can see, this string I added, and it's cutting inside. So let's remove, let's see, just showing you. Yeah, so let's now remove the string and it will show you how to do it. So the main goal is right now is to add 2 lavender strings into loops. 2 lavender to 2 ears. But we'll do first of all this ear and then we'll do this ear. First of all, you'll need to sharpen your string. Like that. Just take a scissors and cut it like that. You see, it's now sharpened. And yeah, I'm going to first take the first string. This will be the longer string. And I'm going to add it through some loops. Now the loops will be, well, let's see. You can see here, this is one loop here, and so this one, this loop. I'm gonna need to add it in between, like inside this loop. Now you can more or less try to figure it out yourself. Maybe, let's see. You can start from the beginning if you want. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. On your 18th loop. Or you can start from here to be easier. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So a 7th loop from here. Hope that I got it right. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah. So this loop, we're going to add it through this little loop. And now, as you can see, we kind of need to open it up. It takes some time, so as you can see. Okay, got it through the first loop, and now we're going to add it through the second loop. Now the last loop will be this one. So now I'm going to take it through this one, and then this one, and then this one. So you may want to do it even straight ahead. I'll show you how I did it. It's better for you maybe. Or you can do it on your own, it's really, you can see you can do it straight ahead and go through all these three. You can see it's pretty easy to do it. And now you have your first string inside all of these. Now make sure your string is at the center of a stitch, like the center of a string. So make sure this and this are even. And let's add our second string. So the second string is the shorter string. This one is the longer, this one is the shorter. So again, it will be very easy if you just sharpen your string. Now let's do it. And finally, going to add for this one, last one. and find your center of a string. And now let's do something even funner. Now I'm going to add the three purple strings. So first purple string, how are we going to do it? So this is kind of fun because you only need to open up one of the lavender strings here. So take off, like open this loop here. You'll need to, 1 second. Okay, see, I have here this short loop here. Open it up, take your purple string, dark purple string, and pull it through. And that's really it, because now I only need to find the center of it and pull it again. And you can see this purple string is inside. Really easy. Let's do it another two times. One here and one here. So take your sharp thing, open this string, and add your second purple through the loop. You can see. Pretty simple. And find your center. And now the last purple. Again, by Rick's Lace, it's called purple, but you know it's dark purple. And add it through the last loop. Pull it through the purple loop, lavender loop, find its center, and close the string. Like, see, it's really, it's maybe the funnest part of this part 5 here. And let's now see. So we finished off adding the strings, and we'll need a right, as you can see, I'm seeing here a left-handed stitch. Okay, let's guess. You can see now going to actually make the stitch. So make sure you know what's lavender to weave. So a shorter lavender will be on the dark purple sides. The long lavender will be on its own. So make sure you know which lavender is which, and we're going to weave. So you can see that this is the long lavender on my side, and you can see that it's leaning towards the left here. So we're just going to make sure it will stay on the left. And this one is also naturally leaning to the right. Well, you can see more or less. So this one might be to the left, this one will be to the right. So these are the long lavender strings. Now, because of that, we'll need this short lavender and these three purple on the left side, and this one will be on the right side because we need four strings here, three dark purple strings and this lavender string here. So let's move in. Moving this guy here. And now we can start to weave. So let's weave it. So this is the first. Make sure that the lavenders are with two short lavenders, this one and this one, are at the edges of a stitch. Make sure again the dark purple strings are at the center, this one and this one are at the edges. And let's just weave. So taking this short one and weave over under. So you can see this one is on the left, this one is on the right. Again, these two are the longer strings. Next, we're going to weave this one because it's the next string to weave, obviously. Or maybe not. Yeah, this one. Okay, next will be this one. And after that, this one. Now, this string, this one, finally, this purple, and this lavender. And yeah, we finished the first stitch. Hooray! Now, because I don't want to make only one, because it looks pretty bad, the first beginning it looks really bad. So let's make another one, and then we're going to move on to the left side, the left ear. Yeah, so let's make another one, and then we'll do the same here. Okay, looks really good. Let's move on to the left ear. Now I'm going to add strings for the second ear, this one. As you can see, the ears are pretty much in the same line. And you can see, add the two lavender strings in between here and here. So let's just move on to our Espeon. You can see, we'll take this stitch and go straight here. You can count this loop, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So in between a third and a fourth loop. Or you can see in between this loop and this loop. This loop from the neck is the sixth loop. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So in between the sixth and the eighth. So add your two lavender strings from here, and then go here, here, and here. And then you're gonna stop about around here. So yeah, let's show you how to do it. Take the long string, and of course you need to sharpen it. Okay, and so take your scissors and we will take it through here. Excuse me. Okay, I found my string. So let's stick it inside here. Okay, see? In between the third loop and the fourth loop on the same line of a stitch of our first ear. And then take it through here and here. It's kinda tricky again, but what you can do is try to make the best of it. So between this one and this one. Good. Now we're just going to follow the same path with our second lavender string. You can see we added three loops instead of four. This is because in lanyards we don't have symmetry. It can be a topic on its own about symmetry. Like, the symmetry of two ears is not that trivial. Symmetry of these two ears are not that trivial, and I may need to make another, whole lecture about it, maybe? Tutorial? I don't know. But anyway, just take your first string, you can see it's clearly where I added it between the sixth fear and the eighth fear. Or you can say a third and a fourth. Then just come here. You can even start from here and then end up here. You can see the three loops here are the same line or order. And let's add our second string. First, sharpen your string. add same place. And see how easy it is when you sharpen your string. You can go through all the three loops instantly without any much effort. So I pour it for two loops, we need one more. So, kind of sucks at first to get through. Come on, let's do it. Okay, finally. Find the center of a string. Find also the two long strings, center of the two long strings. And now I'm going to add the purple strings. So purple strings here is not like this one, it's a little bit harder to do because of that, because of the symmetry of the two ears, we're ending up with something that is not that clear. Because we need to add three dark purple strings. And okay, let's just show you. First, we're going to add the two dark purple strings, and then the third one, I'm going to do it by just making a stitch. So, like before, just taking one of the strings, one of the lavender strings, make a loop, as you can see, a loop here, by just, you know, opening up the string, and then find the center of the two, center of a purple, then close it off. Here you got your first loop, your first dark string, and then you're gonna do the same thing over here. See, opening up the first loop, and then taking the dark purple, finding its center and closing it off again. Now I'm going to make the stitch, and then at the end of the stitch we'll add the third string. You may ask, why is it different from the first one? Well, I'll say only one word. It's because of symmetry, and symmetry in lanyards is quite different from other things, and you need to make two different stuff on the ears. So here we'll need to first make the stitch and then add the third string. Okay, it's a video on its own, so let's just move on. Okay, so a third, the longest string here is this one, so we'll need to take this string will be on the right side, and this string will be on the left side. From down to up will be on the left side, you can see here, left, from up to down will be on the right. And then the shorter lavender string will be here, will be on the left side, and this one will be on the right side. So let's just go from here, then leaning towards here. So this one first, over under. Okay. And then this dark purple. And then this one. This one. Our last dark purple right now, and then this one will be on the right side, from right to left, closing up the stitch. And now finally we'll add a third string. Third string will be needed to be added. Well, let's see. First of all, we'll need to pull the strings. Okay. Now you can probably see that we need to add a third string here. Okay, because we need a string a little bit on the upside of a head. So take your last third dark purple string, and right now add it in between this dark purple and this lavender over here. And just finding its center of a string, and I'm going to weave it. Okay, finding the center, and make sure it's in between this one and this one, between this loop and this loop. Okay, and weave. It's a little bit dark here, sorry about it. This is what we have. Okay, see, the new string is here and here, in between this and this. And let's pull the strings and make a stitch, a second stitch, and we'll be done for this part. Now you can see, try to perfect the stitch as much as you can, and we'll continue for the last stitch of this long video. Excuse me for this to be too long. So one here, one here. Yeah, I think we done a good progress this part. Maybe it was a little bit longer than usual, but I think it's for the best. Okay, so yeah, that's pretty much it. See, this is what we'll get at the end. Next part we'll finish up the ears. And yeah, so see you next time.